When I say Fitbites with Fredna, I assume it's always mental, physical, spiritual, and everything included.
Hmm. So what prompted you to start a channel like this? I know you are you're already a trained professional, you have work and you counsel a lot of clients, but why a YouTube channel? Why do you think this message is required?
So yes, of course, as you're right, being a physical therapist actually helps. So I have this personal interest in fitness as well. When I was since I live in the US, now in Canada actually, so a lot of people have asked me, because whenever I give my advice to them, they will be like following for 2 days and then they forget. So most of them, what happens was like they were not regular. So giving them a video of something, demonstrating something where I'm not actually physically present, helps them to have a routine. Mm-hmm. So the aim was to basically help my mom and my mom-in-law to start with, because they were the ones who were complaining the most and they were expecting a lot of out of me whenever I was trying to give them the advice, but they used to forget. So I thought I'd make kind of videos so that people can follow.
So going by the current trend, we are all in locked in situation, and I think it will extend for a few more days. So many people are adjusting to work from home. So when you go to office, you have a comfortable setup with a nice chair. These are designed to work. At home, we don't have places like that, right? So in my case also, I have a lot of problem in the neck area, in the hands when I'm using the mouse, and a lot of physical strain. So do you have any advice on to how to solve this? Any simple exercise that we can do sitting in a chair?
I can discuss and show you bulk of exercises, but like we'll just try to keep it short and sweet so that people remember, because if you're putting too much information, they don't remember. Okay. So when we are sitting, so if we just assume when you're sitting, what happens is like you're looking in the screen most of the time, most of the people either writing or looking at the screen, working from home, even for housewives or whosoever. Cooking and your everyday work involves a lot of bending of your neck. So first and foremost, when we look at the body, when you are doing this bending for a lot of time, even like scrolling your social media, doing a lot of work on your mobile. So for that, you know, your neck is always flexed. So when you are doing this for like 10 hours continuously, you need to give your body a break. So whenever I suggest people, it's like ergonomic, either you invest in an ergonomic chair. Well, that is one thing. And then you invest in yourself, like you do exercises. You get up every 20 minutes, first of all.
20 minutes.
Okay. 20 minutes, 20 to 30, maybe like I'm just giving a range, but it's necessary because your body adapts to what you're doing. So after a certain time, you'll be more comfortable in this position or in this position, but you will not become in the original sitting position, which is expected, like you have to be straight. So when we talk about exercise, we have to deal with, every person is different, every person's posture is different. So it's very difficult to like give a sure shot thing. So five basic stretches that I usually recommend for people who are working on computer a long time, even while working at home, would be, first of all, is a very, I'm just going to demonstrate. I don't know how you're going to understand or not, but yes. So you just use your index finger, keep it on your chin, and you just do the chin tuck. So it means you're trying to basically create a double chin when I do this. So it's basically my cervical spine in a neutral position instead of this position. It's a basic reminder that I have to keep my neck like this. So when you break that neck flexion posture, you're basically reminding your muscle that, yeah, that is not the true thing. The original movement is this. This is what you have to do. This is one exercise. So whenever you do it, just keep your finger like this on your chin, and then maybe like hold it for 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, and relax. Again, do this. Now do this frequently throughout the day. 20 minutes break. After 20 minutes break, then do this exercise. Then we always slouch like this. So to counteract that, we have to either sit straight and then do some stretching. So you keep your hand at your shoulder level. I hope you can see me here.
Sure.
So you keep your hand at shoulder level like this, and you brace your shoulders back. So when you brace it, you have to hold it for 5 to 10 seconds. Try to keep this shoulder, the hands at the shoulder level. So the back of the scapula or the shoulder blades will move like this. You will feel the movement, and it might be painful for a lot of people because we do like this. So the muscle has accommodated to this position that is more comfortable for you. So you're trying to break the chain. So you do something like this and you hold it for 10 seconds and then you just relax. Then you do this, you break the pattern. Okay.
Okay.
This is,
it hurts here.
Yeah, it will hurt, but once you do it, so body adapts to what you're doing. So if you start doing this, within a few days, you'll be much more comfortable. Instead of 10 seconds, you'll be able to hold for 30 to 60 seconds.
Okay.
Now, talk about full body. So when you're sitting, your legs are bent.
Mm.
Okay.
Yes.
So for, I usually suggest you take a towel roll and then you put your ankle and then you just stretch your body. Now here I can just demonstrate if at all you can focus. Let me just shift the focus. So most of the time we have a chair like this at home and not the ergonomic chair. Okay, and I'm just for the demonstrating, I'm sitting like this. Okay, so I don't have a towel, but I'm just demonstrating. You do, you wrap the towel around your ankle like this, and then you stretch. What we are doing, we usually sit like this. Our posture is like this. So we are tilting our pelvis. So you keep your body straight.
Okay.
You hold the towel, and
okay,
then you just stretch. Stretch for 30 to 40 seconds. Again, to break that pattern, what you're doing, whole hours and hours of bending, you're just trying to break that pattern. This is not going to be easy, but still, once you start doing it, you'll feel that you're more and more comfortable. So this is the third exercise.
Okay.
The fourth exercise would be, you just cross your leg like this.
Okay.
Okay. It's a very good hip opening exercise.
Okay.
And it's pretty good for sciatica as well. So people with back pain, especially those who have knee pain as well and problem in sitting while on the floor, so they can even adapt to this. You sit on the chair, try to make a figure of four. You just cross your ankle, one side, one leg ankle over the knee or thigh, and then just press it. You'll feel the stretch here. You just stretch it sometime. Then you repeat on time. So this will be like 30 to 40 seconds, then gradually, and always be gradual when you're doing exercise. It has to be very gradual. No abrupt movement. So, and there's a thing that one side would be tighter than the other. So when you do this exercise, your one side will feel tighter, but gradually with practice, it will loosen up. And it's good for sciatica. It's good for hip stiffness.
Hmm.
It's good for hip pain. It's even good for knee pain because it's actually stretching your thighs.
Okay.
So this is... this was the fourth one that I usually recommend. We're trying to target main parts of the body, like, you know, because in this short session, it's just difficult to do a lot of things. So I'm just trying to maximize whatever we have.
Hmm.
So this is the fourth. Now, when we talk about, again, sitting and day-to-day sitting like this, we don't do much movement. Right? So for this, I usually recommend, and people can actually gauge their flexibility and strength and start doing this one. This one's a little bit complicated, but not that difficult. So you just sit on the side, keep your legs. So depending on the height of the chair, so it's a lunge, but on a chair.
Okay.
Okay. So you lunge. Can you see the full leg? I don't know if you can.
Oh, I can't see, but I understand you're on the knee, right?
Yes. So, so based on the height of the chair, your knee might be touching the ground.
Okay.
Be in this position and then you do like this. Now this will stretch your mid-back.
Okay.
Okay. So this has two or three purposes. So it's stretching this, it's putting it on the front leg, it's stretching the back leg. And when you do the twisting, it's actually working on your thoracic area. So you twist like this, hold it for 10 seconds, gradually come back to the neutral position. Do on the opposite side. Now, people with good amount of strength and good amount of flexibility may even do this to make their lunge even like broader, like this, and then just stretch.
That looks difficult. The first one.
It's actually a modification of the original lunge. When a lot of people cannot do those lunges because of pain, because of stiffness. Mm-hmm. So we basically give them the modified version. This is one of the modified version. Mm-hmm. But if you can't do that, we can even break apart that movement. All you have to do is hold something, mm-hmm. which can give kind of sense of what is straight. Mm-hmm. So okay, let's just pretend.
Okay.
So And then you just twist, okay? You twist and you come back. So you can hold a dowel or anything you have at home, a pipe. Mm-hmm. Hold it like this and then just twist and you come back.
Okay.
So this is for your mid-back.
Mm-hmm.
Then last but not the least, you just interlace your finger like this, stretch your body in the front, and then you take it up.
Mm-hmm.
And then you keep on breathing. You never hold your breath for any exercise. You always keep on breathing like this.
Okay.
And then you do this.
Okay.
So we have kind of covered major areas which we can hit. Now, talking about when you're using the keyboard, you're using your fingers a lot. Oh. This squeezy thing actually helps.
Okay.
People think it's not working, but your hands have so much of small muscles. So when you use a ball like this or this, okay. you just keep on squeezing. So it actually gives sensory information to the nerves.
Okay.
One, actually massages your palm, and then there are small muscles, those get activated, and then based on the reflexology, this is a good thing to do. So you're actually massaging your organs. So there are like muscles like this. So you do this for your hands.
Okay.
Okay. Now for the a very important thing, and it's like a recent research that I came across. So you use a lacrosse ball or you use a tennis ball.
Okay.
Okay. And here I cannot show you. So assuming this is your foot,
okay,
your standing position, you just roll this ball out. Okay, you just roll this ball in. Okay.
Okay.
So again, what I said, the sensory receptors, the neuroreceptors, everything actually gets activated when you're massaging the feet.
Mm-hmm.
So you give a good real sensation of your feet, and there are so many small muscles.
Mm-hmm.
So those muscles even in your foot.
Hmm.
And then the reflexology part of this, so you will feel some relief in your body even well when you do this. So like 3 minutes a day each foot.
Okay.
So you can just break it apart, right? Like anytime you're not doing anything, you're just trying to see something.
Okay.
And you can just do this. So these are the exercises which are like very effective. I try to include those in my daily routine whenever I get time.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I recommend. Like rest all would be like more of a personal thing, but this is what I recommend.
All right. So today's session, we learned about 5 or 6 techniques that you can sit on your chair without a lot of effort, relax your muscles and do. To see more information and more exercises like this, you can visit Prerna's YouTube channel. What is the channel, Prerna?
Fit Bites with Prerna.
Fit Bites with Prerna. I'll share the link in the video. So till next time, if you have any other suggestions and requests, please send. We'll get Prerna to do a free consultation.
Oh, sure. Online, yes.
Yeah. All right.
Okay.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.